right, so this is day two for my guy, you know, before he goes and take his MSF course, or more like MSS, motorcycle, you know, safety school, and get his certification, get his license updated. So this is day two. Last day is gonna be on the 17th, and then he's gonna go and he's gonna pass, right? Yep. You're gonna go and you're gonna pass, right? Maybe. Definitely. You said maybe?
Yeah, I'm gonna pass.
Nah, you make it happen, man. All right, so today, the main thing over there for the course that the most difficult is the figure eights. The figure eights and the U-turns. But mostly the figure eights. You're gonna have you in a box like about three parking spots. One here, one, another one. That's how big the rectangle or the square is. It's about that big, about three parking spots, or maybe two, maybe just two. And then it goes like all the way to like, so like over here, Stanley, like to right here. And then they have you just do like a 80. That's like part of the exam. That shit is tough, bro. I didn't even think I got that shit right the first time I did it. But you know, you're allowed to get certain points, and then a certain amount of points to pass, a certain amount of points to like execute you. It's like to eliminate you and shit like that. But let's get it popping. Let's get it popping. So today, pretty much, you're gonna pick up from yesterday, right? Do it maybe like one or two times, get comfortable with that. And then we're gonna do the slow ride, where I'm gonna actually walk next to you, like from over here down there. I'm gonna walk right by you while you're on the bike. You're already doing it, but I'm gonna just walk by you. And it's gonna be like, you're gonna be on this side, I'm gonna be here. I'm gonna just walk by you, just keeping it at a slow pace, because you're gonna need that in the real traffic. And then once you get that down packed, then the next thing we're gonna do after that is probably like turns. So like you'll come out with the bike and then make a turn, like you had the stop sign. Yeah, and then we'll work on a U-turn. The U-turn, you use three parking spots. You just go in. You don't have to come all the way this far. You can go as far as here, come in, and make the turn out with a U-turn. So let's get started. Whatever else comes to mind, we'll do. But you can hop on, start it up. Yeah. All right, that kickstand in. Yeah. From what I told you, you gotta, yeah, so you turn it off for now. This is how you turn it on. Put it in the on position. You have to turn the key to your right. Once it's on the on position, turn all the way to your right. So you don't have to push it down. Yeah. And then put it in the center. Leave it here. When everything is good, you're ready to start it. You just click it over, you're gonna start. That's it. So now it's in neutral. Remember what I told you? In order to switch the gears, you have to pull the clutch in, and then the shift the first gear is down. Got pressed down on it for the first gear. Your shoe screen might want to tie or put it within. All right, so remember, like if you see it's in first now. Well, don't worry about the stalling. That shit happens to everybody, you feel me? But I told you already, the only reason why it stalls is if you let this out too fast, then it's gonna stall. So for now, since you're facing this direction, you're gonna go straight, come around this way. Remember, we're staying in this area, same area as yesterday, because the car's going out that way. So you're gonna go straight and come around this way. And then we're gonna go back out a long way. You know, just get that little dust off of you from yesterday to now, you know? So like I tell you, anytime you feel uncomfortable, pull the clutch in and hands on the Go around, take it around. Give a little bit of gas. Keep going, you good. All right, slow down a little bit. What I want you to do before anything get caught up in anything, put in neutral first, and you gotta fully tie your shoes, because your strings will get cut. Look at your strings. It's in neutral, right? All right, see your shoes? Make sure the kickstand is up first though, and then you can hop out the bike. It's down? Yeah, then lean over. Huh?
What's this thing I keep hitting?
Oh, this is the center stand. You can lift up the bike and work on it. So either get rid of those strings or put it, you know? Because the last thing I want that shit to get caught up in the chain.
Yeah.
That's not a good look, you know? Yeah, so both shoes, same thing. So the next time when you get back on, right? You're gonna go, you did both of them?
Yeah.
All right, that's good. But I'll keep monitoring that just in case it comes out. When you get on the bike this time, once you start moving, you're gonna take your hand off the clutch. Once you get out and the bike starts to move and you're giving a little bit of gas, you're gonna release this a little bit. When you're turning, you're feeling uncomfortable, yeah, you can pull it back in and then control your turn and then turn to come back around. When you go all the way around, I'm gonna be standing right over there. And then I'm gonna walk with you while you're on the bike. I'm gonna walk with you. So you keep a steady pace, steady walking pace while you're riding. All right? But just go around for now, I'll meet you over there. Yeah. Cause that slow ride is so important, man. When you're in New York City traffic, kickstand up first. All right, clutch all the way in. All right, first gear. You click it down. No, you gotta click it down. First gear. Okay, you can put your left foot down. Put your left foot down. Put your right foot up first, covering that rear brake. And then once the bike starts to move, no front brakes needed. Once the bike starts to move, then you put your foot up. Put your left foot up. Left foot up. Put it stall. All right, because you release the clutch too fast. So click it back into neutral. All right, good. And release the clutch. All right, you didn't have to, but my bike, you don't need to pull the clutch in for that. So pull the clutch back in. All right, click it down. It's in first gear. Put that foot back on the ground. Right foot up, make sure you're covering the rear brake. You don't need a front brake at all because we're doing it real slow. So have a full control grip on this, right? So when you're bringing it, you're able to do that a little bit to keep that power going to the rear. So now remember, once this come out, if you release it too fast without giving it gas, the bike is gonna fucking die.
Right.
And for now, you wanna keep it in the friction zone for a little bit. You remember when the bike started to move? Keep it in the friction zone until you feel like your both legs off the ground and you're good. And then you continue giving a little bit of gas and just go around. And when you're making your turn, you can pull it back in, slow down, control your turn, rear brakes, clutch, and turn around. I'll meet you over there. Alright, so at that pace, once you straighten up, we're gonna go straight down. So give a little bit of gas. Straighten up the bike so you don't have to, yeah. Give a little bit, yeah, straighten up. Cause now I'm gonna walk with you. Right there's good. Pull the clutch in. Alright. So try to make it the habit. Once your bike is in first gear, you put that foot back down on the ground, right? And you put your right foot up, covering the rear brake. Not pressing on it, but just covering it. Now you got your balance. You wanna keep that balance where the bike at least landing on this side. It's more like your foot is a kickstand. They know on that side. Now, once the clutch starts to go out, once you feel the bike moving, you stay right within that friction zone. You can let it go out a little bit more, you get more power. If not, you keep it right there, steady, and you're giving a little bit of gas. You see where your hand positioned?
Yeah.
You want to have your hand on that, okay. Right? Not get crazy where you just spread that shit over you, fucking hurt yourself. So I'm gonna walk next to you at a slow pace, and we're gonna go all the way to the white car. So when you're ready to start moving, I'll follow. He's gonna just do a walking pace. But both foot up, both foot up. Good, good. You're going too fast. Slow down with the rear brake a little bit. Slow down with the rear brake. You can just tap it, let go, tap it, let go. All right. That's too much for you?
No. So I'm gonna go with the lot.
Yeah, that's the friction zone.
Right, that's the friction zone.
So once it starts to move like that, that bike.
Tap the brakes and just stay.
No, what I'm saying, like tap it like this, put over a little bit. Just so you don't have to press it too hard, just a little bit like that. And then once you feel like the bike slow down enough, you let it go and start to move. You know, just like, you know, like that. Like, okay. But at the same time, you're still giving it power. You can hear it sound like it's choking, like, rrr, rrr. Yeah. Because I want to walk next to you, because the slow ride is definitely something you need to have control over, you know? For live traffic, and plus over there. Foot up, foot up, foot up. You're good, you're good. Keep going, at that pace is good. Keep going, give it gas, give it gas, give it gas. It's not gonna go no faster because you got the clutch pull in. Yeah, like that. Well, you just look, you're ahead of me, but keep going, keep going. I'll meet you on the other side. We'll try it again on the other side. Come on, go back on the side. Come on, side. Alright, that's slow enough. Yeah, keep going. Stay at that pace. Wait, shut down again? Yeah, trust me, get used to that, man. No, you're not giving enough power.
So, you want me to slow just on that?
Let me show you. Let me show you what I'm talking about.
Okay.
Yeah. Sure. I got it. Yeah. Alright.
You want me to walk it?
No, because the reason I want you to do like this is when you at the training class, they're gonna tell you to like move the bike as slow as possible. I'm gonna show you something real quick. Let me turn this bitch back on. They're gonna have like cones set up and shit, right? And I'm gonna come around on the other side right there, and then we'll start to do it. So yeah, you see like this. Like that, right? The reason why they're having you do that in the school now.
You were hitting the clutch, right?
Huh? No, I had my hand right here the whole time in the friction zone. I was just doing with the brakes until I got my balance. I was just tapping. See, every time I was like going like that, I was tapping with the brakes a little bit just to get that balance. And I still had the power going to it.
Okay. That's
what I was like. So I'm gonna meet you over there, and you're gonna see. Like, you stand on the side where you can see me. When I come around, go ahead. When you come around, so you can see what I'm doing. Yo, this is so important when you're doing like regular traffic. This is so important. All right, so I want you to stand on this side. Let me move the bike up a little bit more. All right, so this is so important for the school, because most of the stuff you're doing is slow pace. You feel what I mean? I love my brother car, but it looked like it though. It's, most of the stuff you're doing is slow pace, but he got tinted windows. It's slow pace. So one of the training is gonna tell you, okay, get on the bike and go from here to here as slow as you can. That's one of the other things that they have you do. So what they want you to do is keep the clutch in the friction zone and give it power. And then once you're giving the clutch in the friction zone and giving it power, pretty much meaning like have a little bit of power coming in the engine, because the bike is not going to go nowhere. I could do this shit. It's not going nowhere once it touches pull in. Now, when it stays like this, right, and then I let it out a little bit, it starts to move. I'm still holding the power the same place. It starts to move. Now, it would stay like this once my feet is up. Look at my feet. It's up. You see? That's how much power I'm giving it. So now I control that power by slowing it down more, by giving a little bit of rear brake and just keeping my steering, controlling my steering and looking up. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna do it now so you can just check it out. Like, all right, we're going. Just walk, walking distance, you'll see. You need that for like live traffic. And you're not doing it for that long in traffic anyway. Just like in one of the rush hour shit, where like fucking bumper to bumper shit, you know? Because you don't want to do that for too long, because that would damage the clutch, but it's good to practice and know how to do. You see how that was that walking pace? Try it out, you know, it's a little challenging, but it's good to know how to do it in case you're on your bike. You don't want to be one of those bikers where you're like this for traffic. You know, you're like this. Yeah, you like duck walking that shit while traffic is moving. That's fucking insane, bro. You learn how to do the slow ride and control that shit, you're good. So try it out, right? I'm gonna go around that side so you start off over there. Try it out, and then after that, we'll do something else. I'll meet you on the other side. You can hop on. I didn't put a kickstand on. Yeah, so you'd be more comfortable. You can hop on. So we'll do that for a little bit. Get used to that, because that is so helpful. And then after that, we'll start doing like fucking turns and shit. But most of our turns we're doing is going to be on that side, because there's no cars. Yeah, so same thing applies. First, yep. Put that foot back down. All right, now put your right foot up. Don't press on the rear brake, just covering it. You know, resting your foot over it. Now, once the bike starts to move, you pick up this leg, and then, all right. You probably let it out too fast or something. It's all good. Just click in neutral. All right, take your hand off of this. Start it up. All right, pull the clutch back in. Click in first, that foot down, that foot covering it. Look forward. Remember, once this starts to move, and you feel like you got enough power, and then you pick up your left foot. Pick your left foot, a little bit of gas. You control your speed with the rear brake. Just keep giving it gas though, and keep that clutch in. All right, good. That's good. All right, go around the other side and do the same thing. You're doing good. Are you gonna win that way? I want you to stay in this area. All right, so that was pretty good, you know, at that pace. So now turn the bike this way, I'll walk with you. All right. Now keep in control, keep the gas going. And just mess with the friction zone only, just like that. And, you know, when you feel like going too fast, you slow down with the rear brake. And that's it, just control the bike, you know. And keep your body, keep, make sure you're looking straight ahead of you. All right. Huh? You're moving a little fast, but it's okay. Yeah, keep the clutch in the friction zone. You have to let it go out. All right, that's good. Give a little bit of gas. Good. Nice. All right, so turn around, we'll go back that way. You're gonna do it one more time and that's about it. I just want you to learn that because that's something they're gonna have you do at the class. They're gonna have you do it at the school. So remember, you wanna keep the gas, you wanna keep it steady. Wherever you decide to bring it to, bring it, give it a little bit of gas. Keep your hand steady, meaning by not moving it, just keep it right there. Remember, the bike is only moving based on the power it's getting to the rear. So if you feel like you're moving too fast, you can either pull this in and let it out, pull in and let it out. I feel like that's too much for you to learn. So keep it in the friction zone and just use, and stop it and increase it by letting your foot off. Your foot will be easier because it's something you already do in your car. Yeah. So it's easier for you to go like this than to go like this. Right. You know, because that's something you got to learn. But it's easier to just keep it in that zone where the bike is moving and then keep the gas right where it's at because it's not going to go no faster than you allow it to. And then you just keep your foot on the brakes, tapping a little by little to slow down to control your speed to keep yourself steady. And that's it. We're gonna do that to was your car, and that's pretty much it. But that's something to always practice because it's important. So go ahead. You're already in first gear, so you're good. You gotta let the clutch out a little bit. Bike starts to move. Keep that gas going. Keep the gas right there. Keep it steady. Keep it steady, just like that. Don't let it go. Keep it steady. All right, just tap that rear brake every now and then to slow it down. That's good. You're doing real good. See, I'm doing a little speed walk, but still good. All right, keep it like that. Keep going. Don't let that gas go. Don't let that gas go. Gas.
It's hard to control.
Huh?
It's hard to control.
I know, because once you're able to control the bike like that, you have more control when you're going at higher speed. Because that's what it takes. Like, once this gas going to this rear, the bike would not fall.
Yeah, it's hard for me to move and then not like.
No, you have to do it. You have to do it as if you're on a bicycle. You know how when you're a bicycle, you like this.
Yeah.
You could do that. You could do it like that, but long as you're just keeping your body up straight. You see, when I was doing it, I was like this, like that, because you have to until you actually get that momentum where you can keep it straight. But you don't have to keep it fixed. You know what I mean? Just keep the bike going straight. Just be like this until you get that control. All right. Once the bike starts to move, foot up. All right, covering that rear brake. Good shit. Keep going. Yep, keep going. Because what this is doing is teaching how about balancing on the bike. You're doing good. Just look straight up. You already got everything going. You got your foot on the rear brake. You got gas going to it. You know, you're in the friction zone. You're good. You're good. Don't worry about that. You give it more gas if you want. But keep the gas steady. You're doing good though. You did good. Alright, so that's good. Good shit. But when you get your bike, right? When you come to a parking lot like this, always practice that. Because when you're in like traffic like this and people in the fucking like this, stop and go traffic, you have to be able to keep that balance on the bike. Yeah, and then when you see like it's a way, you just cut out the way and just get out of it. But if it's fucking gridlock traffic where the cars are so close together, you can't even go between them. Because with my bike, when I'm out here and I see the traffic is locked in, that's beautiful. I see a pathway, I'm going right through the shits, right between cars. And like, if you knew it, you're not confident enough, just throw your hazard on, right? People could see you. You can see a reflection, see that. Especially when you're on the highway. When I get on the highway, I have to do that. I do that now when I'm in regular traffic. When I get that confident up, get on the highway, I'm gonna do that when it's gridlock traffic. And I see there's an opening, I go right in between it, slow ride. My speed's a little bit more than the cars, because the cars are moving so slow. Slow ride, like about 10, 8, just going through them. And then when I see traffic picking up, I get in the lane, whatever lane, I'm going the right lane, I jump in that lane, increase my speed, and then move the traffic flow. When it slow down again, hop out, slow ride, right through all the cars. That's how you do it. That's why the advantage of having a bike. To fucking just go right through this fucking car. You don't have to wait for shit. All right. So now, when you go around this time, what I need you to do is stay right there. Just look at me. Oh, you come around with the bike? I need you to stop like right here. To come around, stop like here. And then we're going to start to work on like the turns. Thank you. Yeah, come in this box right here. Right here. Turn. Here. You coming here, Stanley? All right, fuck it, don't matter. Just come into one of these boxes. All right, that's good. You can stop right there. Stop right there. That's good. So now, the reason why I had you do the slow ride, because when you're doing your turns, you're going to be doing mostly slow ride. You keep it in friction zone. You got gas going to the rear wheel, to the engine pretty much, and you're covering that rear brake. So I'm going to hop on and show you what I want you to do first. You're going to go make the U-turn, come back. You know, the shit is not... All right, is it neutral? Good. You're going to go make a U-turn. You have three boxes to work in. Anyway, you're going this space, this one, and one, two, and three. So you're going to kind of make the U-turn, come all the way back out, come here, and make the U-turn again, and go back out.
So let's say I'm not going past that manhole.
You're staying, you see this white line right here? You're staying in here. You can get as close as you want. If you go over, no big deal, but as you do it more, you get comfortable. You stay in this triangle, this parking spot, so you can go as far out here as you want, but don't go over this line. So you're gonna be in this parking spot right here. You got all the space to make the turn. Okay. You're gonna be in this parking spot, and you got even up to here in this parking spot just to make the turn here. And you're gonna go up. This I'm gonna do it, but let me just explain. So you're gonna go up this way with the bike. You got enough to go make the turn. You're gonna come here, and then you're gonna go back over there and do the same thing. Just like it's a wider U-turn, you know? So pretty much, when you be in the friction zone, you're gonna have more control. That's why you're doing a slow ride. Cause you're doing a slow ride, but the only difference, you're turning the wheel and you're just turning with it. And now you have, you're going slow so you can move the handlebar. When you start going fast, you're gonna push it this, I'm gonna show you that too. You're gonna push forward and push that way when you wanna go this direction. But for now, since you're going at a slower pace, you're controlling it and just turning. So I'm gonna do it so you can see. If you're not feeling, comfortable, like you go to the fourth box, no big deal, you feel what I mean? But long you do the U-turn. And that is just so important, even though you're not gonna be doing a lot of U-turns in real life, but it's about the control. It's not about the actual U-turn itself, it's about the control of the bike. Once you get the control of the bike, you could do crazy shit. Hold on, let me. Like, you can do shit like that with the bike. But you gotta first have that control. Once you got the control, then you can do crazy shit like that. Because when you're in traffic, they don't give no, like with all the shit I got on, nobody see me when I'm in traffic. So I'm on go time when I'm in traffic. So you can make it happen. Let me bring it back a little bit. Remember, this is on a hill. So once you put your foot on, once you release this, the bike is gonna start rolling back because you're on a hill, technically. So you know what? I'll start you on the other side because that's kind of a flat surface. So let's start. You good right here? All right, cool. Yeah. So remember, you can give it more power, right? But the main thing here is to keep the bike in the friction zone, especially for the turns. When you're going, you don't really have to so much, but when you get to where you're cutting, you want to keep it in that friction zone. Don't let it out no more than that. And you can always, you see how the bike was sounding when I was doing it?
Yeah.
You can always give it more power. Don't even worry about that, because this could stay here and you can keep tapping it with the rear brake. Whenever you're feeling like you're losing control, tap it, slowly tap it, tap it. That's all I was tapping the brakes, tapping the rear brakes until I make the turn. Tap, 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 tap. And then when I get straight, I let it go and start to move. When I get close again, tap, 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 until you make the turn. But take your time. You got three boxes to work out of, but if you go into the fourth one, no big deal. The only focus is to make the fucking turn.
Okay.
Feel me? So I'll be over here. Remember, keep, you don't, we did yesterday with a circle. That's what you're doing. As you go there, you'll learn, you're turning this way. And then we're gonna do it in the opposite direction. All right, first gear. Yeah, you got this shit, man. Give it gas, put up. It's all good, it's all good. Put in neutral. That's what I was saying, the hill. With the hill, you have to already have power, you feel me? That's how I'm telling you to start on the smooth side, but you say, hey, don't worry about it. You're already in first gear. So keep, pull that, yeah, I usually start in neutral, but I don't worry about that shit.
Okay.
All right, clutch is in. Give it power, have power already, have gas already. Get it steady. Move it, move the gas, move it. Give it a little bit more, a little bit more. Right there, hold it steady there. And know that once you let this out more, you let this out a little bit, the bike is gonna move up. Shit. Don't be nervous, man. You got this. All right, look. Right there. Keep it like that. All right, do four boxes. Fuck it. Take your time with it. Take your time with it. You can go out if you want. Go all the way past that and turn around. Whatever's comfortable. Keep power. Keep. You want to keep the power going to the engine. You want to keep it steady. Keep the power steady. You see how you're gripping it? You have your fingers open. Have a grip on it. Turn. Good, good, good. Good shit, good shit. Remember, you have the rear brakes to slow you down when you feel like you need to. All right. Look this way. Look at me. That's how you're supposed to feel. That's how you're supposed to feel. Like you're about to just fall and bust your ass. So just keep the power going. Keep the power steady, right? If you're gonna feel like you're about to fall if you're looking down while you're turning. But if you're keeping your eyes in the direction you wanna go, the bike is gonna follow. Remember, you already got power going. Don't let the power go. Keep the power steady there and keep the bike in the friction zone. And if you need to slow down for any reason, don't even move your hand from here. Just tap on the rear brakes, your foot is already over it. Once you tap on the rear brakes, the bike is gonna slow down. And you just turn your bike as if it's a bicycle, because you already got power going to it. You'll be good, man. You got it. You did it one time over there already, so you gotta repeat yourself. You're gonna have to get that feel like you're about to fall, so. All right, so go ahead, start now, since you're facing forward. Keep the power steady, have a grip on it, have a grip. Have a grip on the
Yo, dude, it's a Okay, hold on a second.
No, I'm saying like have a close grip on this, right? So you can have more control. Because you have your finger open, you like this. This is how you turn it. Move your hand real quick. You're turning it like this.
Yeah. I feel like I need to turn, and then when I hold on to it too much, I don't want to WTF.
It's so good.
Slip off and then the bike just goes fucking going off.
It's not though, because you have your foot covering that rear brake. Trust me, you're not even in second gear. You're good. All right. So for now, go this way, get comfortable, come back. Look where you're going. Look at me. Keep going. Look at me. Good. All right. Keep going. All right. Now look at me. Yeah. All right. Good. I turn. Same thing. Keep going. Keep going. Look forward. Now look at me. Look at me. Turn. Turn. Turn this way.
Also, my hand is hurting.
Because you're actually squeezing this tight as fuck for your life. All right, so fuck that. We'll try.
No, I'll get this. I'll get this.
Yeah, I want you to get it down packed.
I think it's off now, right?
Yeah, you could. It'll be the one time you take this bitch off and you fall and you're like, but you're good, my guy. Don't worry, you're good. We'll leave from here at 3 o'clock. Okay. So you got another 30 minutes, so you're good. At least you got the slow ride down, you got control on the bike. So I want you to get the U-turns in, and then we're gonna do regular turns. Left, right, left, right. Foot up, foot up, foot up. Once the bike is moving, foot up. All right, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Look at me, look at me. Turn, 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 turn. Look at me, look at me, look at me. Look this way. Keep going. Keep that power going. Good, good, good. All right, look straight. Now start looking at me. Turn. Keep turning, turn it. Turn the bike, turn the bike. Nah, it's this uphill right here. When you're going on, when you see when you're over there, it's easier because you got momentum going down the hill. When you're coming up here, that's when you have to pull it in. Remember, you're tapping it down. No, it's already down. It's in first gear.
Okay.
So you don't have to do anything. Once you see the one, it's first gear. You're good.
Woo.
All right, now it's in neutral. Okay. Yeah, okay. Well, your hands are hurting?
Yeah. No, it's just like working out.
I don't know. Now you will. Once you get the U-turns, that's good. Then we'll do more. You do the circles.
So you're powering through. You're holding the power.
No, no. All right, let's keep it simple. You already know that the clutch is right there.
Yeah.
When you release the clutch, the bike starts to move. All right, right when the bike starts to move.
Sir, I'm letting go of the clutch, right?
No, you're not letting go of it all the way.
Okay, but my hand is covering it.
No, no, no. You, what you're doing is that.
When you have pressure though.
Huh? Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So when you go like this, and I say, okay, when the clutch goes out, when it gets certain, like right here, the bike starts to move, all you're doing is getting it right there. You're keeping it there. Because now you want to have a smooth control for now. Because you could do this without the clutch, but because you're learning. So you have a smooth control right there. And then, why is here steadily? You have your gas already at where you need it to be. You're keeping your gas right there. You can always give the gas more. And when it starts to go any faster, you're already covering the rear brake. So you tap on the rear brake and the bike will start to slow down.
Right.
Start to slow down. And once you take your foot off the rear brake, it will start to go. But you're already there. You already got the gas. You already got yourself in the friction zone.
Yeah.
Just keeping that control.
I stopped because I feel like I'm tilting. I'm about to fall. Yeah, I don't know how to lose control of the bike.
Don't worry about that. Yeah, it's all mental. Don't worry about that. This bike, it's going to fall. It fell already for me.
Yeah.
In the fucking, and I wasn't even on it.
Yeah.
I was in the driveway and getting out the driveway and I started the bike and went whoop. And I was standing like right here. I started the bike and it went vroom. I said, what the fuck? I wasn't even on that bitch. So don't worry about this shit falling, man. If I bought it to not hit the ground, I should have kept it in the fucking showroom. I just don't want to hit the ground in some critical shit. All right, so start looking. Start turning. Turning your head while you turn the bike. Good. You doing good over there. It's up here. Come on, you're doing good. Keep going. Now start turning. Slow down. Tap it. Remember, you don't want to lose control.
Yeah, I know, but it's hard to like keep it at that steady rate, but move the bike. Because as soon as I move
this
it,
is why this is what I'm telling you. Like, even if you're giving it more gas, when you pull this bad boy in, it starts to cut engine from the rear wheel. So if the gas is already, that's how it's gonna sound because it's already pulled in. So if you're feeling uncomfortable, you can pull it back in. But just remember, if you don't let it go to get back in that friction zone, when the bike already completes the turn and it don't have enough momentum, you're gonna go down. You feel what I mean? So it's best that you play with it, like where you pull it back, go forward a little bit, get back in the friction zone, because you kind of already know what the friction zone is. And you're just keeping the power here. And you're just tapping on the rear brake. That's it.
So I stick with my hands instead of my feet.
Exactly. So now what we'll do, since the three spots is too small, go wider. Don't even worry about the boxes. Don't worry about the boxes.
Okay.
Forget about all this shit. Just focus on doing the turn. It don't matter if you go wide enough, but just stay within this area. Just do the turn. Don't worry about the boxes shit. All right, do the same thing up here. That's better. That's better. Just keep doing it like that. That's good. All right, now you're gonna go in the reverse. Yeah, the opposite. Yeah. No. You're doing it exactly like that. Come this way and turn this way. And now start turning this way. Yeah. Same thing, just make the U-turn the same way, that way. The direction you're going in, just make the U-turn.
Okay, this way?
No, remember, you're doing the opposite of what you're just doing.
Okay.
That's all.
Okay.
So you're going back over there, making the U-turn, come back up this way, same thing. And then we'll switch it up, we'll do the right turn, left turn, try that out. We're gonna move your eyes where you're going. Like you're looking down more the controllers than you're looking in front of you, and you're keeping your neck stiff. Good. Look here. Good. All right, go up, make the turn, go around. And make the turn this way. No, you're still going back that direction. You gotta go the opposite now. Come straight up, make the U-turn, go around like this. Yeah, circle this way. Yeah, you're going to your right, Stanley. You're still going to your left. You're supposed to go to your right. You can do it from over there. Just turn this way. Turn this direction. Go down, turn to come back the same way. All right. Turn to your right. Keep turning. Turn. No. Yeah, Stanley, you're supposed to go this way. Why you keep going back the other way?
I'm sorry.
Huh?
I'm sorry. You want me to do a figure eight, right?
No, I just want you to do the same U-turn.
Oh.
That's all you're doing. You're just doing the opposite direction. You're just doing the opposite direction, because I remember I told you can do as many circles as you, many spots as you want, because you're not staying within a three space. I don't even do figure eights that well. Why would I want you to do it yet? All right, so come straight to me. Come straight up, right? You're making a right turn and going around. You're coming back.
Make your right, my bad.
You're making a left again.
My bad.
Go straight up, make the right turn, go this way. You're coming this way. Turn. Turn again. Turn. Do it one more time. And then we'll stop and we'll do something else. Remember to move your neck. You gotta see where you're going. You see, you keep looking down. You can stop. You keep looking. I know you got your glasses on, you think you're slick, but you're still looking like more towards this area and you're looking down. You wanna be moving your neck. Cause if you don't get accustomed to moving your neck while you're riding, if somebody comes, because remember, my bike only had one mirror. If you was riding this on the street and you're not moving your neck and you fuck around looking this direction, but you're moving like this, somebody can just boom, smack you. You don't want that. All right, so for now, I'll have you do the turns, but you're gonna do the turn at a pace. Like, you see how you was doing the U-turn just now? It's just a little, I wish I didn't bring my cone. On Sunday, I'm bringing the cones, I'm gonna set it up for you. So I'm gonna hop on and show you what I'm gonna do. But you can throw it in neutral. Go in neutral, put the kickstand up. It's in neutral, right? Yep. Kickstand down. You can hop out. So, we're gonna have like a mark. That mark is gonna be where that brown shit is on the floor. Okay. That's gonna be our turning point. So, they will have you do it in a narrow space. But for now, since you're practicing to get your control, you could do it from the center. You can do it the left side, right side, whatever. So you're gonna go, I'm gonna do it first. You're gonna go around, right? Get here, slow down, right? But you're only going to turn into this box. There's no like fucking up where you turn into that box, none of that. This shit right here, that's our turning mark. Once you get close, when you feel like you're right here, then you can start to turn this direction. And once you get here, once you turn, it's okay. You can go like over here, U-turn, whatever. But just for you to be able to turn into your right. And then eventually, when you get comfortable with that side, we're gonna get like right here. Or once you see this line right here, you start to turn this way. Just to get comfortable. You can turn it and get the bike straight and then stop if you want, if you're comfortable. And then you turn the bike with your foot, whatever, and come back around again. But if you get it down packed with the friction zone and the gas, you can make that turn and go back around and come and do it again and go this way, do it again. What that's going to show you is like when you're at a stop sign, right? Then you're going to be able to make a turn. So I want you to do it without stopping. And then after that, we're going to come here. We're going to stop right before the line. I'm going to probably get like a bottle or some shit. We're going to stop right before the line. And then once the light changes, pretend the light changed. And then you're going to turn this way with the bike. And the same thing applies that way. So I'm going to do it both ways so you can see. Because that's part of the test. That's something they're gonna have. They're gonna say, okay, drive. When you get over to that cone, stop, and then turn and merge into traffic. They're gonna teach you all this shit, but at least if you have some kind of foundation, it's easier, you look better. And plus, you guarantee the pass because you're more confident. I'll be in the friction zone now. I'm in the friction zone. I'm coming here and I'm turning and going straight. That's all you gotta do. You don't have to do that and make another turn. You're turning at an intersection to go straight to the other side. All right, so I'm gonna do it in reverse. I'm gonna do it a couple times. Right now I'm gonna do it when I stop and I'm gonna make the turn. So now I'm coming to the stop sign. The way I usually do it, I'll come to the stop sign, I'm like right here, slow down a little bit, and then I just turn. But the way I want you to do it for start is put your foot down. So you're gonna pretend that there's a stop sign right there. You're gonna go, get closer, rear brakes only, stop. And now if you're turning this way, you wanna have your bike at least this direction. You don't have to come to a stop. And when you're doing it, you don't have to worry. You can go into the second box until you get comfortable. Come closer, come closer. You can go into the second box if you're comfortable when you're making a turn to go to your right. And the same thing applies when you're going this way. Because all you're doing is keeping in the friction zone, giving the gas, and just controlling with that rear brake. See, right now I'm out the friction zone completely. So when I start moving, you know? So now I'm at a stop sign. There's like a, it's a right turn. So I'm here, I'm waiting. I got my bike this way a little bit. I'm already giving it gas. I'm holding the gas steady. Now once the bike starts moving, once I let this go, I lift my foot up on the rear brakes. Cause the rear brakes is keeping me like this. If I'm on a hill, it keeps the bike steady. If I'm on a decline, it keeps the bike steady from rolling off and shit. So now I'm giving it gas, holding the gas right there. Now, only thing I'm doing now is letting this go out a little bit. The bike starts to move. And that's it, and I'm gone. I'm gonna do it on the opposite side. All right, I'm at the stop sign. I'm going this way, but I'm going into that lane. You see, at first I was really close. I was like right here. So I was able to just make that turn. It was much tighter. In most cases, the streets are not like that. It's like when you stop, you have the little curve on the sidewalk. So then you have your bike leaning this direction to make it easy because you're already going this way. So then the same thing, give a little bit of gas. Your foot is covering that rear brake. Look how my foot is covering the rear brake. See how my foot is covering it. See where my foot is at? My foot is not like here. It's not over here. Your foot was like right there. You want to have your foot like right there. You have more control in your toes when you point it down. So you have your foot like that. It's more balance. You got gas going to the rear tire. You're going out the friction zone. The bike start moving. You can increase the engine. It's not gonna do nothing because you're controlling with that brake. You know what I mean? So you can increase the engine up. You're not gonna do much. So if you want more space, you can do it from that side. Because if you feel like it's too tight, but I think this is okay. So you're gonna do hop on the bike, go around, make a right turn first, no stopping, make a right turn, come back around, make a left turn, come back around, make another right turn, get comfortable with it. And then after that, then you're gonna pretend it's a stop sign, stop. You can stop in the center, stop on that side. But we're considering this to be like one lane. Even if it's fucking wide, but you know, because we're practicing, this one lane. So if you're making a right turn this way and you feel more comfortable standing over, having your bike over here, it's okay. If you're comfortable having your bike in the center so you can turn into the lane, that's okay. All right. So for now, just go around. Don't even worry about the turn. You can turn any way you want. Just go around until you come back over here. Kickstand up. It's in first gear. Yep, covering the rear brakes. Give it gas. No, keep it steady. Keep it steady, steady, steady gas right there. That's good. Now you know, once your hand goes out, the bike is gonna start moving. So keep the gas steady, release it out the friction zone. Bike starts moving. Foot up. This time you're not stopping. You're just making a turn into that box. Just making the same way you just did. Just make that turn and go back around again. Good, 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 good. Just go back around. All right, so now come this way more. Oh, you cut too close. Cause I want you to turn this way. You turn into this box and go back out that way. Turn. Yeah. When you come in, when you do it the next time, right? Come from this side, Stanley. Look, Stan. When you turn, yeah, turn and come this way. To make it easier, then you just cut into that. All right, now start turning. Turn into that. Turn into that. All right, another U-turn. Turn. All right, good, good, good. All right, so turn again. Turn the bike. Yeah, go that one more time. Try that one more time. Turn this way. The same thing. Make that left turn. Make the left turn. Make the left turn. No, I don't want you to stop yet because I want you to do... This is the easy part. You don't have to stop. So go back around, right? Get comfortable with it. Do this like one time. Go left one time, comfortable. Come back around. Go right one more time and then go left. Then after you do it twice, you come back. Then you stop and then you make the turn from the stop. So for now, don't worry about it. Just turn, go around. Go right first, go left, go right again, and go left, and then come back and stop. All right, you're turning this way first. Don't stop, just turn. All right, now you're gonna turn into this one. You missed. It's all good. All right, come back around. You're gonna go this way now. Are you gonna turn into this one? Don't stop, just turn. Not bad. You turn into this lane. You come straight, you turn into this. You missed a little bit, but do this again. Do this side again. Turn around, turn. You're turning this way. Turn this way. Into that lane and make the turn. Yes, yes, yes. Good, good, good. All right, do it one more time. Go into the whole lane. Go into the center. Go into the center. Go into the center. Center. All right, it's okay. It's all right. No, I want you to turn in this lane. That's what I've been saying. Like, you turn into that lane. I want you to turn into this lane. Because this is considered like a street. Yeah, do that one more time. The other side, you're good. With your right side, you're good. Your left side is where you like, I don't know what's going on, you know? Good, good, good. Do it one more time. One more time. Don't stop giving it gas, you know, because you're gonna bike gonna feel like it's gonna fall. All right, that's good enough. All right, come over and stop. Come straight and stop. Yeah. Yeah. Good. 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 Boom. Okay. So now. I want you to turn right from the stop, so it's okay if you go out that way and you still make the turn. And then the same thing gonna apply, you're gonna do it this way also. You're only working in these two parking spots, but if you go over the parking spot, it's okay, no big deal. So keep the clutch pulling, roll the bike back, walk the bike back a little bit so you have more room. Yeah, so a little back a little bit more. All right, good, because now this is where the rear brakes really count, because when you let the bike out the friction zone, it's gonna start to move. So you wanna tap with the rear brake, control it while you're turning to get into this parking spot. You can get here, it's good. Here, it's good. Anywhere here is good. Once you get in between these white lines and turn, that's it. You can go straight, turn, whatever. But once you turn this way, that's okay. Just get in the habit of doing that, and then you're gonna do that next side. Okay. Not bad. Just do it one more time. All right, so come to like a full stop. There's the stop sign coming up right here, full stop, boom, stop. Your turn signal is on. You know, your bike is already in first gear. You got gas going to it. You're making that right turn again. You have your bike lean a little bit this way because that's what you're doing, just a little bit, not too much. So you can kind of get a start on the turn. And then you're making sure you're looking both ways, left, right. There's no cars coming. You have the stop sign. There's another stop sign. Okay, so I'm the car. You ready now? I'm the car. Okay, I see you. Over my stop. I'm waiting for you to go. That's why you always gotta be ready. I'm waiting for you to go. And then if you do shit like that, then the car starts to go. You know? All right, so come to a full stop. Yeah, come to a full stop, rear brakes only, foot down, good. Now, I'm over here, right? So once, just be ready, right? Be ready. Once I walk and get here and stop, turn, all right? So you're looking both ways, left, right. Not yet. All right, go around, come back around. Oh, you get back up? All right, cool. All right, so remember your wheel's already there, you got power's going to the rear, your foot is, everything's positioned, you got gas, everything. The only thing you're doing now is getting to the friction zone and you're turning going. So once I get to the end of the line, turn, because I'm going to come to a stop. So I'm coming, you look, just make sure, boom, I stop, it's your turn, go ahead. Good shit. All right, come to another full stop. Yep, beautiful, nice stopping. So now we're gonna do that again, and then after that we're gonna do it on this side more, because this side you have a problem with. So, all right, you're looking, I'm the car, I'm coming now. You got your gas already up in the friction zone. I see the stop sign, I come to a full stop. I'm waiting on you to go. It's so good. Come to a full stop again. Let's do it one more time and that's it. All right, full stop. All right, good. Now, same thing applies. Once I get here and I come to a complete stop, turn, all right? All right. No, you're going that way still. I want you to get it right and then you're gonna come this way. So I'm coming, ready, set. Come to a full stop. Good. Not bad, good. All right, come to another full stop. So now this is more uphill. So if I was you, to give me more room, I would have came like over here. Because remember, this is one big ass street. Streets are not this wide, but I would have came like at least here. So when I am turning, I have more room to work with, but maybe you could do it. So same thing applies. I'm gonna walk this way. Once I get here and stop, you make that turn into that box. All right, so you good? You're giving it gas, you're covering that rear brake. All right, clutch pull all the way in. You let the clutch out a little bit, just a little bit, not all the way, the clutch. All right, so now I walk up, I stop. All right, go ahead, take your turn. All right, one more time. All right, full stop. Keep going. Right about there. That's the stop sign right there. All right, so make sure you're covering the rear brake. The bike is stopped. Keep your foot on it. Your bike has come to a full stop. Now you're giving it gas also. Keep the gas steady. Because now it's one of those moments where if I get to the stop sign, right, and you see that I don't stop and I start going, you already stopped completely because your foot's on the rear brake. So now Give it a little bit, keep the gas steady like that. Keep the clutch pull all the way in. I'm coming towards you now. I'm at the stop sign. Come to a full stop. Boom. Now it's your turn. You gotta make your left turn. Not bad, not bad. Good. All right, so that's all good. So now what I want you to work on, and then maybe next time when I come back and I bring the cone, then we're gonna do like the swerving and shit. Cause it's kind of hard to tell you to swerve this way and swerve that way, but it is what it is. We're gonna do like emergency stops now.
You gotta go though, right?
Huh?
It's 251.
I hear you.
It's 251.
No, we're leaving at, we're leaving at 3. Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll do like one or two stops and then that's good enough. All right, so you can throw it in neutral. So the last thing we're gonna work on when you come back next time is gonna be like trying to do some kind of figure eight, right? And also get into second gear, getting you into second gear. That's the last thing. And then once you get able to get in second gear, get a little bit of speed from here to here, and then you can be able to stop. So for now, I'm gonna show you how to stop if you come into like an emergency stop type thing. In first gear.
I'll put you guys fixing that.
It's all good. All right, so when I get to this, I'm gonna stop the bike before it goes over the brown little thing on the floor right there. Oh yeah. I mean, you did tell me that. It's all good. Shit happens, bro. All right, first gear. And now when I'm coming to emergency stop, what I'm doing is, even though I'm not going so fast, but just to practice it, I'm pressing in the front brake. Now this is where you're gonna use the front brake, just to practice emergency stop. You're gonna use your two fingers, but if you're comfortable, use your whole hand. And you're only going front brakes first, slowly, and then rear brake right after to come to a full stop. So watch, I'm gonna do it real quick. That I use every single finger. So I'm gonna do it like one more time so you can see. I'm gonna do it one more time, right? And that's so important, because if you're in the traffic and these motherfuckers just step on their brake, you can do that, you know, but you're always watching. So when you see something like that, swerve out the way, you're out of it. I'm gonna do it one more time, but for you, you can use your whole hand. For me, I usually use it on two fingers, but when you're doing it, use your whole hand. Front brake first and then rear brake follows, then you come to a full stop. If you use only front brake, the bike would jerk. I'm gonna come back around. To do it like one or two times and that's it, we wrap it up for today. So just going around, go around that parking area thing, and then come back and try to come to a stop before here. And you might hear the bike like going because it wants you to switch the gears, but don't worry about it. So just come to a full stop when you get over here. Do your thing. Alright, give it some gas. Alright, clutch pull in, everything, yep. Not bad. Just do it one more time. But I want you to get as close to the, yeah. I want you to stop before this. So do it one more time and then that's it for today. Nice, nice. I like that. Good shit, good shit, good shit. Slowly. Boom. Beautiful, beautiful. That's good. So throw it in neutral. It's just the only thing is that when you get into second gear, when you're doing that, you're moving like 20, 25, you might have to pull in a little bit harder to become more aggressive. So the bike will bounce a little bit. But once both brakes are pressed, it will come for that full stop. Yeah. But you got it neutral?
Yeah.
Kickstand down. All right. Yeah, we're about to leave. I'm about to head out.
Okay.
Yeah, so we kind of done for today. So Sunday will be the next time. We're gonna do like figure eights and shit.
Yeah.
And we'll get you in the second gear, shifting from like first to second and back to first. First to second and back to first. Cause at the class, you're only gonna go up to the highest gonna be second gear. You're not going to higher than that. And the top speed they're gonna have you do is 18. And they might tell you, oh, push it to 20, but they're not gonna have you go like 25, 30 and shit like that. All right, Stang, good shit.